Good afternoon, guys. How are you? I hope everything goes well. For our today's session, we're going to see the module 3, the explanation about the topics we have to study, as well as the different description about the activities we're going to do during this course. Bienvenidos una vez más a nuestro curso inglés básico 1. For our today's session, we have module 3. I hope that you can advantage of this module, right? So in here, we're going to see the main topics according to this module. My name is Angela Garzón, I'm 430. So we have the general feedback at submitted activities, the grammar review for module 3, the module 3, the different texts, and the final comments. The general feedback at submitted activities is the following. Es muy importante, queridos estudiosos, que ustedes tengan en cuenta como tal las observaciones que van a venir a continuación para de esta manera hacer un trabajo exitoso en la presentación de cada una de ellas. So first, it's important to submit your assignments on time. Extra time will be issued upon certain conditions. One of these conditions is that you are going to be graded with 4 at maximum grade. Entonces recordemos que una de las primeras sugerencias que se hace es que ustedes entreguen las actividades a tiempo. Dado que de lo contrario, digamos que estas ciertas condiciones que ustedes puedan tener cuando se evalúa una actividad con un tiempo extra, esa va a ser calificada sobre 4. Don't forget to do your assignments with enough time so the students' homeworks were incomplete. Es muy importante que ustedes hagan una revisión del taller, de la actividad que vayan a presentar, dado que en algunos casos se encuentra que ciertas tareas están incompletas. Por ejemplo, en la tarea de Where Lie on the Slide, it was pretty common that some of the points were incomplete. So that's why that's important that you start looking through the activity and just start working on it day by day. Entonces es muy importante que ustedes puedan asignar un tiempo a la realización de cada una de las actividades. Always double check the instructions for each activity. Algo también que es muy importante para notar es que es necesario que ustedes hagan una revisión de las instrucciones para cada una de las actividades. And avoid using translators because they don't help you at learning at your best. Cuando ustedes no hacen uso de los traductores, en este sentido, pueden, como tal, hacer la búsqueda de ciertas palabras en contexto, pero no hacer una traducción literal de la oración, dado que este pues, no es un proceso como tal que permita afianzar el conocimiento. So, the grammar review for module 3, it's basic on likes and dislikes, the use of the connector but. The use of modal verb would, dislike, and light, okay? Lights and dislikes. As we have in here, we have this picture, this image, which represents what we like doing, what we dislike doing. Entonces recordemos, este va a ser nuestro primer tema de trabajo, conectado con el conector but and. But we use to contrast information, it depends according to the situation we refer to. And modal verb would. Recordemos que el would es el ia del verbo que le sigo. I would like to. Entonces me gustaría ir. I would like to travel. I would like to sing or whatever. All right? Lights. Do you like sports? What sports do you like watching on TV? According to the first question, is a yes-no question. Podemos decir sí o no. Do you like sports? Yes, I do. No, I don't. Does she like sports? Yes, she does. No, she doesn't. Podemos ver ahí la modificación como tal del auxiliar dependiendo del sujeto. What sports do you like watching on TV? Oh, I like watching soccer on TV. I like watching basketball games on TV. Are you interested in going to the cinema? Oh, yes, I feel interested in going to watch any kind of movie. What kind of movies are you interested in watching? I love watching horror comedies, which is not true, but okay, there is an example. Comedy movies, I loved watching them. Entonces, aquí en este apartado como tal, nosotros podemos ver el uso de el auxiliar do, right? Like do and doing here, are, which is the there is the main verb to be, but it's the conjugation where we have you, the same as here. Do you love traveling on vacation?
Yes, I do. No, I don't. I think that most of us, we love traveling because it is one of our favorite activities in order to know places, in order to do other things. Where would you like to go? I would like to go to, we can say Hawaii. I would like to go to Medellin, whatever. Yes, you're going to choose one place you would like to go. I like it, but. Entonces, aquí tenemos el uso como tal de algunas expresiones o, en este caso, la gramática en referencia a las preguntas. Entonces, tenemos ciertos ejemplos en contexto. So, we can use what is first, what kind, or where. Yes, all of them are using WH questions. Or we have another option, which is to put do or are, or it depends according to the use that we really want to give to that. I like it, but. So in this part, we use but to contrast information in order to show something you like and something you dislike doing etc. Entonces recordemos que en este caso el but lo que hace como tal, o el uso que nosotros hacemos del mismo, es contrastar información de manera que nosotros podamos mostrar que nos gusta hacer tipo de actividad a diferencia de otra que no nos gusta. There are some examples in here that I'm going to read for you. She likes eating fast food, but she dislikes eating fruits. That's the first one. The second one. He loves eating seafood, but he hates eating junk food. They're crazy about drinking milkshake because they have not tried. So in the first one, you can see right there, we have the use of likes. Yes, that's with S because we are just mentioning a third person. And in here, dislikes, just the conjugation of this third person as well. Like this grammar is used for the second and the third, yeah, but for the second we have third person. For the third one, we have second person in plural. That's why we use in a different way. Are crazy about, recordemos que say are crazy about, como tal denota una connotación, algo que nos encanta. Entonces, ellos son locos por tomar malteadas. En este caso, digamos que en el contexto que estamos hablando de las comidas, podemos hacer uso del esta, como tal, de esta expresión. They are crazy about doing something. As you can see right here, we have the use of ing after like, love, dislike, hate, or crazy about. Entonces, como ustedes pueden ver acá, el verbo que sigue va con ing para que lo tengan muy en cuenta, luego del uso de like, dislike, love, hate, or about. Esta es una preposición, generalmente siempre después de las preposiciones nosotros vamos a colocar ese verbo con ing. Would you like? When we use would you like? So the first use we have is when we really want to invite people to have something to eat or drink, we can use it. Would you like to drink milkshake? We also use this expression to make invitations to activities. Would you like to go to Paul's birthday? As you can see right there, we have two options. One of them is correct, the other one, well, it's just like something that we can make. Entonces, ¿qué te gustaría en este caso tomar? Aquí vemos que la gramática es un poco diferente. Siempre que nosotros tenemos el would, este va a ir seguido por el to. En este caso, como es pregunta, por eso lo ubicamos aquí después del like. Yes? But it is the same case when we had a positive or a negative statement. I wouldn't like to drink. I would like to drink. But would, yes, or is just in this place, after subject, like to, the verb, the main verb in present, and the complement. And the other option we have is to use, like when we really want to make an invitation to any kind of activity, we use would plus the subject plus like to, the verb in infinitive, and the complement as well. Entonces aquí sabemos cómo está la forma gramatical, para que ustedes lo tengan muy en cuenta, y sabemos que tenemos dos usos. Uno, pues que hace referencia a invitar a las personas a tomar algún tipo de bebida o a comer algo. Y el otro uso es la expresión que hacemos para hacer algún tipo de invitación a cierta actividad. All right? So there are some expressions we have in here. We're going to read them in order to learn more about it and to practice with some examples. Likes and dislikes. I love sleeping. I can't stand working up early. As you can see right there, entonces vamos a ver esas expresiones en contexto. Las palabras que están allí con rojo hacen referencia al verbo principal del enunciado. Entonces, para que ustedes miren muy bien si es de vacunarse, entonces, ¿por qué hacemos referencia? Sabemos que es tercera persona, si estamos hablando de alguna actividad, de algún lugar, etcétera, right? And, or like this one, there are like an expressions, or right here, there are some expressions which are in red. But in the purple part, we're going to see the complement. So, like, I love sleeping. I can't stand working up early. As you can see right there, you can see the contrast of that. I'm crazy about reading comics. She really likes dancing salsa music. He enjoys watching football games. Right there, with those four examples, we can see the use of love, crazy about, likes, and enjoys. Entonces sabemos que el primero, pues no le agregamos ese porque no es tercera persona, junto con el segundo, pero ya en el tercer y cuarto tenemos el uso de likes, lights and enjoys, right? After that, we have the verb followed by ing and the complement. Listening to music feels good. Yes, there is an expression that we use. En este caso, sabemos que no tenemos un sujeto, sino que estamos hablando de alguna actividad. Escuchar música nos hace sentir como bien. Entonces, aquí es muy importante tener en cuenta que cuando utilizamos el feels, we have to put here, right, the action that we are talking about. After that, the verb with S, yes, because just as an activity, like third person. And like the expression, or in this case, we use an adjective. Watching that movie this weekend sounds good. Eating pizza tastes good. And going to a concert looks good. Dislikes. So for dislikes, we use other expressions. Recordemos el significado de estas expresiones, como en este caso, me encanta dormir. Me encanta leer libros de cómic, right? Entonces cada una de ellas como tal representa algún tipo de emoción que en este caso hace referencia a un gusto o en este caso una actividad que no nos gusta o odiamos hacer. I can't stand wake up early. I can't put up with commuter by bus. He's sick of studying on Sundays. He started working at night. Being stuck in traffic jams drives me crazy. Getting lies from people bothers me. Using public transport annoys me. Como ustedes pueden acá fijarse, dentro de los primeros cuatro ejemplos, vemos que tenemos un sujeto, el verbo que le sigue con ing y el complemento, a diferencia de los otros enunciados. Entonces, si utilizamos el feels, or drives me crazy, bothers, annoys, tastes, sounds, or looks, we are going to put the activity first, after that, bird, and after that, good, yeah, or me. It depends according to the contents of the sentence as well as the intention of the speaker. Entonces, tenemos acá dos dualidades para que ustedes tengan en cuenta muy bien esas expresiones. So, later we have, like, the different tasks that we're going to start working with. Entonces, aquí en este apartado vemos la explicación a nivel gramatical, vemos el uso como tal de las expresiones, tengan muy en cuenta el uso de el verbo, los verbos que están en presente simple, yes, which we studied before, yes, in order to practice them. So in here I'm going to show you like the three different activities we have for this term, so in order to let you know about them. So basic one, so we have in here the following information. Recordemos que ustedes pueden explorar los recursos que tenemos dentro de nuestro material complementario para la realización de cada una de las actividades. Pueden encontrar diferentes tipos de juegos, actividades de vocabulario, de gramática, entre otros. When you come here, you just click on models, and in here you're going to see all the information we have for this model and for this course. So we have the PDF, the starting material for this model, lights and dislikes, the complementary material for in this part, you're going to see some games, some activities according to grammar explanation, yeah? So questions about lights, expressing likes and dislikes, verb to express preferences, and some vocabulary games as well. Also, we have for these four, three different activities. The first one is a workshop, es un taller. The second one is a forum, un foro, y finalmente el examen final. For the workshop that we have in here, that's going to be available until this period of time, we're going to see like just some examples. I like it, but. So in this part, we have 6 questions. This one is shorter than the previous one. So in here, what we are going to do, we are going to watch this video about bird behaviors around the world, and then according to the information, match the behavior with the country where it is considered root. Entonces acá en este caso debemos ver el video que está relacionado con ciertos comportamientos que se consideran rudos dentro de determinado país, y a partir de allí escoger la información que hace referencia con el país, considerando como tal pues la regla o digamos que tenemos dentro de cada contexto. So to give tip, word is like a rude behavior. So based on the video, you just click an option and choose the best one. All right, this one is one of our best first exercises we have. Entonces tenemos el taller. En un segundo lugar vamos a mirar el foro, which the foro implies that you're going to make a part from yourself, and the other part, it's going to be like the intervention according to one of your classmates' videos, all right? What You Come is the title of it. When we have it in here, so we have the following information. So there are the competences, the description of them. Recuerde siempre mirar como tal ese apartado, ya que aquí se describe paso a paso las competencias que nosotros vamos a desarrollar a partir de la realización del ejercicio y a su vez los pasos a seguir para una realización óptima del mismo. So, to make use of a specific slides and dislikes first in order to relate one's favorite and uncomforting activities through the completion and information in a format similar to a common social net. And to make use of a specific lie and dislike verbs and excuses to accept or reject an invitation to an event by reporting a reply in a forum. Facebook format. Entonces, lo primero que vamos a hacer es descargar el formato de Facebook, que lo pueden encontrar aquí. You just click on here and you start working on it. So with this format, you're going to fill out the format. You're going to focus on some expressions related to likes and dislikes. Each part of the format includes examples, so you can follow the patterns to write each sentence. And remember to check the learning material for third month. In this part, entonces encontramos ese formato que está en Word. La idea es que ustedes pueden completar toda la información que tenemos allí, que es desde el uso de imágenes hasta la creación de párrafos u oraciones. So, in this part, I'm going to show you. All right. So here we have the Facebook format. It's as very similar to the profile of Facebook, yes? But there are some differences we have established. In this part, you're going to fill out this information, which is related to your profession, if you're a student of what career, where do you study, where do you live, likes and dislikes. So in here, en este caso tenemos ese espacio, hace referencia al la imagen que ustedes deben de colocar alusiva a las películas que les gusta, que no, y las razones, right? So in this case, for example, you can put a photo of a horror movie and then you can say the name of the movie and how you feel when you watch it. So in my case, watching horror movies drives me crazy because I hate them. Because I usually dream about those things at night. Yes, that's why. Y así vamos a completar todo el formato. Entonces vamos mirando como tal la información que nos piden, y a partir de ahí vamos a incluir imágenes y texto. All right. So later, in the last part of the format, you have to create an event considering the directions of the activity. En la última parte del formato, nosotros encontramos un evento. So this event is a creation that you're going to do, right? According to one, you're going to describe what is the name of the event, or who is the person who is going to be in charge of doing so, when it's going to take place, what time is going to be, the address and the description. In this fourth idea that you are going to describe the event, yes, but just try to do very short, try to give as many details as you can. Entonces, en esa parte del evento, la idea es que ustedes hagan una creación del mismo, completando toda esta información. Aquí en la descripción, por lo menos, más o menos unas 10 líneas para que se incluyan detalles importantes del mismo y podamos hacer una invitación a nuestros compañeros a dicha actividad. So, after that, which is the second part, you're going to look at one of your course main spots and choose two events from all the pots and comment the reason you would like or wouldn't attend to that fictional event. Entonces, una vez sus compañeros como tal coloquen el formato, lo suban a la página, lo que vamos a hacer es que vamos a escoger dos de esos formatos y vamos a comentar la razón por las cuales a nosotros nos gustaría o no nos gustaría ir a esos eventos que son de ficción, alright? This one is just the second activity, and finally we have the final test. That's all for today. I hope that you have a great day. This one is the explanation for this model. Any questions, don't forget to contact me through the email, yes, which is from Canva, so you can just contact me like through a message. From Monday to Friday, I'm going to be available from 7 in the morning to 4 p.m. and on Saturdays from 7 to 11 p.m. That's the whole information for today's session. I hope that you have a great day today. Bye-bye, guys, and see you later.